In this example, we want to simplify and evaluate using the sum and difference trig identities listed here below in red. So the first step is to recognize which identity we'll be applying. Notice that we have the sine of pi over 2 times the cosine of pi over 6. Well, the sum identity for cosine has cosine A, cosine B, so that's not going to work. So we'll be applying the sum and difference identity for the sine function. But we'll be applying this from right to left, meaning we're given this form of the identity, and we're going to rewrite it as the sine of one angle. So let's go ahead and write this. So here we have the sine of angle A times the cosine of angle B. Notice how we have a minus sign, and then we have cosine A times sine B. So A is equal to pi over 2, and B is equal to pi over 6. And because we're using the subtraction sign here, we'll also use the subtraction sign here, so we'll have the sine of A minus B. And since A is pi over 2 and B is pi over 6, this is equal to the sine of pi over 2 minus pi over 6. So now if we obtain a common denominator by multiplying both the numerator and denominator by 3, this is equal to the sine of 3 pi over 6 minus 1 pi over 6, which is equal to 2 pi over 6, which is equal to the sine of pi over 3. Well, pi over 3 is one of those nice reference angles. That's equal to 60 degrees. So if we sketch a 30, 60, 90 triangle, hopefully you're familiar with the relationship among the three sides. We can label the short leg 1, the hypotenuse 2, and the longer leg square root 3. So the sine of pi over 3 radians, or 60 degrees, would be equal to square root 3 over 2. So this expression simplifies to the sine of pi over 3, which is equal to the square root of 3 over 2. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have the same type of problem, but it's much more obvious we're going to be using the sum and difference identity for the tangent function. So the main things to identify here are angle A, angle B, and then whether we have a sum or difference here, and a sum or difference here. That'll tell us whether we're going to add or subtract angles A and B. So angle A is 12 degrees, angle B is 18 degrees, and then we have a plus sign in the numerator and a subtraction sign in the denominator. So if we use a plus sign here, notice how we're using the top operation, and we're also using the top operation here. Therefore, we'll be using the top operation to combine angles A and B. So this is equal to the tangent of 12 degrees plus 18 degrees, which is equal to the tangent of 30 degrees. So we can use that 30, 60, 90 reference triangle again to determine this function value. The tangent of 30 degrees is going to be equal to the ratio of the opposite side to the adjacent side. So we'll have 1 to square root 3. I'm going to go ahead and rationalize this. So this simplifies to square root 3 over 3. We'll take a look at some additional simplifying examples in the next video where we use the identities in the opposite direction.